Hi, this is Sheshanan. I want to give application on microcontroller, which is password protection system using microcontroller. So actually this video from Eretech Solutions. You can follow us on YouTube. Just subscribe us, the channel name Eretech Solutions, and also Facebook. So the application is very clear from microcontroller, which is password protection system. So this application, which is designed with a combination of microcontroller and keypad and LCD with two different indicators. So this application contains these four blocks as power supply, which is for AC to DC conversion. In electronics, most of the devices require DC power source, so that you need to design your own power supply unit to convert AC to DC. And different devices works with different operating voltages. Whereas microcontroller works with 5 volts DC source and LCD and two indicators, which are LEDs I am using in this application. For successful, green indicator; for fail, red indicator. And this keypad, I'm using 4x3 keypad to attempt my passwords. So this application circuit diagram is very clear. These are the connections I'm doing with this microcontroller. Anyway, microcontroller have 40 pins, and among those you need to use GPIOs for peripherals interface. So port 1 I'm using to interface keypad. So keypad doesn't require any external components. So I'm connecting directly these rows and columns of keypads with IOs. Whereas LCD, so here I'm doing connections with the control pins of LCD, RS, RW, enable. So these three control pins use it for, one for deciding commands or data, what you're sending from controller to LCD screen, and read right, which is RW control pin used to decide which operation you are doing between controller and LCD, whether you are doing read operation or write operation. And enable pin, so this is for LCD busy, and you can use for different activities this enable pin. And for every data or command change, whenever you are sending next new data or next command to LCD screen, you have to make sure enable pin high to low ones. And D0 to D7 lines are the data lines of your LCD screen. And I'm using two indicators, which are green and red, so which are connected across P2.3 and 2.4 pins. So these are my hardware connections for this password protection system application. So come to the source code. So this source code, which is developed in Keil IDE, so most of the microcontroller family supports this Keil Microvision IDE. So even there are other family controllers are there, you can use those IDEs whenever you are using specific microcontrollers. So always these tools are specific. Whenever you are changing your microcontroller, you have to take the supporting IDEs. Now 8051 family supports Keil Microvision IDE. So let's see the source code line by line. So this is the 51 family header file name, and I'm using standard data type, which is S-bit. This is used to define individual pins connections with hardware. So the keypad connections, S-bit row 1 with P1.0, row 2 with 1.1, so like this. I'm just defining all rows and columns with the IOs. And then the control pin connections I'm declaring here, which is RS, RW, enable. From circuit, which are connected across 2.0, 2.1 and 2.2. There is two indicators, green and red. And the functions I'm taking here, one for delay and one for check. And The commands I need to pass to LCD screen, which are 38 0C1080. Some basic commands are required to work with LCD screen for activating crystals and displaying your text and moving your cursor position to right and the cursor position beginning where you are expecting from first line or second line. All those things you need to decide with the help of commands. So these are standard commands. You can get it from Google just by typing LCD commands. These are the list. So with the help of these commands, you can even scroll the messages from left to right or right to left. All those operations we can do. So now the text, what I'm expecting on screen in initial stage, enter password. And this is my secure password code, which is present with the source code. As a user, whenever you are giving these 6 digits of password from keypad, so your system allows to open your green indicator. So the temporary array I am taking to read the 6 elements from this keypad, which is size 6. And the 2 temporary variables, V1 and V2, and other integer variable V3. So now from here, main logic will start. The initial status of 2 indicators, which are 0, so that you have 2 LEDs which are in off state. And P3 is the data lines you connected of LCD screen. So here I am taking first for loop to pass the commands one by one to LCD screen. So this is the for loop. I am executing here the 4 commands, which are 38 and 0C and 10 and 80. So these 4 commands I am passing by using this for loop. See, P3 is equal to common of V1, so that which allows to read these elements one by one from this array. But while passing command, you have to take care of your control pins logics. RS logic should be 0 and read-write logic is 0 because you are doing write operation. And enable pin high to low ones with some time delay. Now, so this, after this for loop, the next for loop I am taking here, which is for displaying my text as enter password. So this is for message of V1, which I am doing 15 times because I have characters 15 on this enter password string. Or else you can display string also with pointer concept, but if you are not understanding all those critical, then you can easily understand this for loop concept by passing character by character, which is stored from this message array. After this for loop, but remember, while passing characters, the one change from this control pin logic, RS logic is 1 and RW is already 0 in the first for loop, and I'm doing every time this enable pin high to low with some time delay, because for every change of character you have to make sure enable pin high to low once. And the next command, which is 0xc0, so this command for moving your cursor position to second line, so that your cursor will wait at second line. Again, you are sending command so that RS logic is 0 and enable pin high to low. This is the while loop. I am entering into this infinite loop while of 1. To work with this keypad, you have to follow either row scan method or column scan method. So scanning methods are very clear. By making one end of your key is logic 0, the other end you can monitor with the logic 0. If you are working with columns, just make sure column logic 0 and check with rows, because each key from the keypad which contain 2 terminals, by making one end logic 0, you can check with other end logic whether it is 0 or remains high. It's a simple concept behind this keypad scanning. First I am making R1 row 1 logic 0. I am checking 3 column keys, either C10 or C20 or C30. If column 1 is 0, what is the character I am expecting on
I'm expecting to store, which is 1. But as a display, I'm expecting star, so that I'm assigning P3 is star. So anyway, passwords are not visible as same as what you are giving from this key patch. You need to display as special characters, but you have to save as a original character value. So I'm saving within this read of V2 as 1, but displaying as star. So if you are not expecting these special characters, you can directly assign as same as 1. So this is simple. Okay, but if you are expecting special characters, make sure any hash or dot or any star, like any special symbol, you can use for display purpose. And then, so again, RS logic is 1, enable high to low. But every time I'm incrementing this index of read array 2 by 1. So you have to store the pressed key from this keypad, and you have to increment your index by 1 second time. Suppose the column 2 logic is 0, storage will be 2, and display as special character star RS, because if it is text or data, you have to make sure RS logic is 1. Enable pin high to low and delay and index incremented by 1. Like this, each and every column I need to scan. For this is for first row. Once row 1 is done, then check with row 2. Again, the column conditions are same, but now I am scanning my second row. For second row, what are the keys from the keypad? 4 for column 1, 5 for column 2, 6 for column 3. The same values I am saving in this array. But display should be special character. Once row 2 scanning is over, then come for row 3. But always remember, only one row is you should scan at a time. You cannot scan 4 rows at a time. Okay, so make sure one row logic is 0 and check with columns. Before attempting third column, make sure second row logic is 1. Now for row 3, again column 1 condition value is 7, and column 2 condition value is 8, and column 3 condition value is 9. Now, so I am coming for fourth row from the keypad, which is star 0 hash. Even if you are attempting for star, the display should be star, and if you are attempting for 0, you are saving 0 and displaying as star. But I am using hash key as an enter key for this keypad. Whenever I am pressing hash, then it will go for comparison, which is already entered from this keypad. So once you are operating hash key from this keypad, so it is going to call this check function. So what is this check function description here? The check function, I am taking two individual messages as per numbers entered from keypad. So the two messages are very clear here: password match, wrong password. If password match, I need to display proper text message on screen, and also I need to turn on green indicator. Let's see this comparison. So password of 0 and read of 0. So read of 0 from keypad and password of 0, which is already saved in my array on top of the program. So I save here 967632. The index is very clear: password of 0, password of 1, password of 2, password of 3, 4, 5. So I need to compare 0 to 5 index. So password of 0, read of 0. And I am using AND operator here, because each and every key should be matched, which is entered from keypad. If any sequence is wrong with your keys from the keypad, so your else part is going to execute. So I am checking here password of 0 and password of 1 and 2 and password of 3 and 4 and 5. Because there are 6 characters I kept as my password, so my index should be up to 5, 0 to 5. Once this condition is matched, then I'm going to turn on this green LED logic is 1, red LED remains 0. But also I am expecting the message on screen. So this message, which is saved in my message 2, I'm just passing through this for loop. So this for loop allows to print my message on LCD screen. Suppose if any character goes wrong from the keypad, then your else part will be executed. And delay function is as usual. So every time this delay will be called between enable high to low. So let's see the output of this program with the help of Proteus simulation tool. So generally your Proteus simulation tool will help us to cross check the application's output if developed in embedded C with microcontroller families. This is one simulation tool which helps a lot to check hardware results. So this application is already designed with the individual components, microcontroller, keypad, LCD and two indicators. If you want to link your embedded C program, you have to make sure your embedded C program converted into hex file. That hex file link you have to apply on this program file option. This is password protection system. Open your file and click on OK. Now you can play your simulation. See, this is the text you may get from this text screen as per your logic. Now I'm typing any key from this keypad, the display should be star. Internally it is going to store as read of index. So now I'm giving some wrong password from the keypad as random keys 1 2 3 7 8 9. Now I'm giving star, sorry, hash. So it displays as wrong password and indicator is red. Suppose if I'm giving right password as 9 and 6, third key is 7, fourth key is again 6, fifth key is 3 and sixth key is 2. After giving all these keys, now you have to type hash as enter key. Now password matched and your green indicator comes to on. So this is the way to check your outputs by using this Proteus simulation tool. This is one simple application with microcontroller, LCD and keypad combination. So if any information required on embedded system training, so just watch our videos on YouTube channel. For more videos, please subscribe us and please comment on your valuable feedback. View, like and share. Any training requirements you have on embedded system, online, classroom and any service you require regarding embedded system, you can reach us with this contact number 9676327118, and our address, we are located at KPHB near Metro Station, Kukatpally, Hyderabad. And any queries, please email this ysnanda@eritechsolutions.com. If you contact 9676327118, so you can call anytime, WhatsApp your requirements. Thanks for watching.